and welcome to another Motion Industries how-to video. My name is Tom Clark, I am your host, and on today's how-to, our video is in response to some viewer email talking about bearing and housing installations. So we figured we'd bring in an expert who knows all about bearings. He's a great guy, you know him, you love him. Please welcome from Schaeffler, Jim Azzalina, and Schaeffler, of course, one of the world's leading manufacturers in bearings. Jim, welcome back, brother.
Thanks, Tom.
It is so good to have you back, but before we begin, you know as well as I do that PPE is so important.
Yes,
right?
Sir.
And he's got his glasses on, I've got mine on. Make sure you're wearing the right PPE for whatever the job calls for. We've got ours. So are you ready to go?
Yes, we are.
All right. You know, Jim, some of our viewers have had problems when changing the bearings because the bearings get jammed to one side. They have asked us to provide a clear explanation about how to maintain the center of bearings inside pillow block housings and how to keep the housing centered. Now, as an example, we have set up a shaft with housings and bearings to illustrate a typical fan application. So, Jim, it is all up to you. I want you to show everyone how to make sure that this jamming doesn't happen. Can you do that?
No problem, Tom.
All right, go.
As we look at this application, we see that there are two housings and two bearings that are mounted on tapered adapter sleeves, along with two locating or stabilizing rings. Now, let's say it is time to change the bearings.
Hey, Jim, it's time to change the bearings.
Okay.
Well, you
One
said
option.
To say it.
That's right.
Okay, good.
All right, one option, and this is the quickest and easiest way to do this, is replace these bearings with FAG split spherical roller bearings. By using split bearings, you eliminate the need to completely remove housings and shafts in the first place, so the problem of having the bearings or housing shift out of place doesn't even come up.
You know, it sounds like a great solution right there. And if this is the answer that you're looking for, they can always view the MiHow2 video that's currently available with yours truly right here, Jim and I, where we demonstrate exactly how to install an FAG split spherical roller bearing. And that was a good video, wasn't it?
It was a good video. But let's say we're going to use something similar to what's set up here, which is a standard solid ray spherical bearings on tapered adapter sleeves. Keep in mind, this type of setup always has a fixed and a floating side. You would refer to the prints to determine which side is which, by the way.
Okay.
If you don't have prints, you want to mark which is fixed when you take it apart. Fixed is the side with the locating or stabilizing rings. Only one of the two bearings should be fixed.
And prints is the side marked with the phrase purple rain, just for those of you that want to know. So, if we have two fixed rings, we're probably in a whole other situation, right?
Right.
Yeah.
We're in a rough situation.
Yeah.
So starting here, we'll want to make sure that once complete, the bearing is centered in the housing and the two locating rings fit on both sides. First, we'll need to determine where the center line of the bearing will be. Then you can install the threaded adapter sleeves onto the shaft and place the bearing in its resting position on the sleeve, referring to our handy tapered bore clearance card.
Now, what are these? What are these called again?
Lock nuts.
Those are from the Lock Nuts Monster.
That's correct.
You know I had to get that joke in there.
I know you did.
Okay.
I know you.
Here we go.
Worked on it.
Okay. So we've got our card here.
Yes.
All right. So what are we looking for in terms of numbers on our chart?
Well, we see that since this is a 65 millimeter bore bearing, we will need to move this bearing up the taper adapter sleeve 20 to 28 thousandths of an inch, using the lock nuts that came supplied with the adapter sleeve.
This chart is a great resource for that.
Now, one way to determine the center is to place the bearing in its rested position on the adapter sleeve and measure from the end of the adapter sleeve threads to the bearing's inner ring. Then, if we measure 1/2 of the width of the bearing and add that to the 20 to the 28 thousandths of an inch more that the bearing will be moved up the adapter sleeve, this will give us the center spot where the bearing will be sitting.
Okay, measure, add, and check. I think we're good to go.
That's right. Now, for the floating side, we just repeat the exact same thing with one exception. We don't add the locating or stabilizing rings.
Why not, Jim?
Because it would make it a fixed bearing instead of a floating, Tom.
You know, that's why we bring you in, Jim, because you've got all the answers. Okay, so that's centering in the housings and installing on the sleeve, but we have more to go to center the pillow blocks, right?
Normally, they would be mounted on a plate, but for this demonstration, they're not.
Okay.
We would refer back to the prints for the center position or the marks that you made during disassembly and measure to get our center point on our housings. We'd make a mark on both the side and front of the housings.
Okay.
You also want to make sure that the housings are properly aligned vertically with the correct shims and that the housings and bearings are square and perpendicular to the shaft.
And then we'd all be center, right?
That's right.
Well, there you go, folks, by popular request, how to maintain our centers when replacing bearings. And we're good to go. Jim, thank you so much.
As
always,
Tom.
Pleasure to have you in the studio.
Thank you.
Thank you for allowing me to use the lousy Loch Ness Monster joke.
Yes, sir.
All right, get out of here. Hey, if you have any questions about anything that Jim was talking about today, don't forget to contact your nearest Motion Industries branch location. They'll be able to help you out. And hopefully this will help you with your practical application when you're working with something like this that you saw here today. And don't forget the proper PPE. Jim and I both had our glasses on. Make sure whatever the job calls for that you wear the proper PPE to keep yourself safe. Thanks so much for watching this video today. Look for other how-to videos with me, Tom Clark, as your host.